Good day, everyone. Our lessons for this week are on. Our lesson for this session is on the elements of story. The following are the objectives for this session. First, enumerate and define the elements of a film, focusing the discussion on plot. Second, name the parts of a plot in their correct order. And third, identify the parts of a plot in sample stories. In order to have right track in this lesson, please be guided with these following questions. 1. What are the elements of a film? 2. What are the parts of a plot and how are they presented in the Freytag's pyramid? Before we go further with our lesson, let's have first this activity. It is entitled, Name That Movie. Be guided by the pictures and letters taken from the movie scenes to name the different local and international films presented. Let's have the first one. If your answer is The Hunger Games, you are correct. Let's have the second one. If you answered Seven Sundays, then you are right. And now let's have the last one. If you answered Hello, Love, Goodbye, then you are correct. Have you watched any of these movies? What made you watch it? Is it because of the set of actors or the storyline? Is it because of the effects or the message that it brings? Every movie is made to entertain. But aside from the entertainment that they bring, they happen to touch the hearts of their viewers, putting realization and reflections linking imagination with reality. Every writer and filmmaker in the entertainment industry is burdened with the thought of bringing out entertainment that will appeal to the people. Bringing the right actors together, selecting the right places where to take events, dissecting the storyline, and totally directing the film could be harder than it looks like. So, what elements make up a great film? Today, we'll be having the first part of the elements of a story. So let's have the basic elements of a film. The first one is character or characters. This refers to the people or animals or real things personified. There can be one main character or many, and often there are secondary characters but not always. Number two is setting or settings. The setting is the location and the time of the action. An author should describe the environment or surroundings of the story in such detail that the reader feels that he or she can picture the scene. Number three is plot. The plot is the actual story around which the entire book is based. A plot should have a very clear beginning, middle, and end, with all the necessary descriptions and suspense, called exposition, so that the reader can make sense of the action and follow along from start to finish. Number four is conflict. Conflict is the bread and butter of drama. Without conflict, the story will have no purpose or trajectory. The plot is centered on this conflict and the ways in which the characters attempt to resolve the problem. Number five is resolution. This tells how the story ended for all the characters. Number six is theme. Basically, it's the central argument that the author is trying to make the reader understand. Number seven is scenes. These are considered to be the building blocks of the screenplay, which are carefully taken by the director or the directors. Number 8 element is dialogue. Dialogue or spoken lines are one of the most conspicuous elements of film narrative. Each line spoken in a film forms a major part of our movie viewing pleasure. And number 9 element is visuals. This element makes film stories at par from other narratives because this is exclusive to motion pictures only. They transcend times and cultural boundaries. Among the given elements, only the plot, characters, and setting will be given emphasis in this module to avoid diverting from the learning competency. So we'll start from plot. Let's have the elements of a plot. Maybe most of you are already familiar with the elements of a plot and how it is usually drawn by your teachers. Thanks to the person who helped them illustrate plot easily. That's in the person of Gustav Freytag. He is a German novelist and a playwright who devised what is referred to as the Freytag's Pyramid, or also known as the Dramatic Pyramid, showing the structure of a dramatic work such as a play or film. So let's have the first element of a plot, which is introduction or exposition. This is where the setting and characters, especially the main character, known as the protagonist, are introduced, as well as the main problem, conflict, or goal of the story. Usually, the introduction is shorter than the other chapters in the story because of the writer's notion that the viewers might skip it because of their eagerness in knowing about what interesting things might happen next. Let's have an example from Harry Potter. I know you are familiar with this. So in the example given, the main character, Harry Potter, has been introduced and some more information such as his age in the scene, which opens to a more interesting scenario. The second element of plot is rising action. The rising action stage involves the inciting incident that pushes the plot into motion. Events begin to build, the protagonist takes action, and the storyline becomes more complex. During this phase, there is often a sense of tension. As it progresses, you'll have multiple moments of conflict that escalate as the story moves toward the climax. Let's have this example, still from Harry Potter. As the story goes deeper, more characters and revelations lead into the most interesting part of the story. Let's have the third element of plot, which is climax. The climax is the turning or the most exciting point in the plot of a story. It involves the central struggle where the protagonist faces the main challenge, which will eventually lead to the outcome or goal of the story. Typically, this is the most emotional part of the storyline, and it often involves the most action. It is in this part of the story that the main character makes a decision that will change the course of the events, but will also make the viewers unsure of what's about to happen. So let's have the climax of Harry Potter as the example. The decision of the main characters in the story can result into unexpected outcomes, which may gain or lose the interest of the viewers. So as a writer, it is expected to study the plot well to be sure that what you set as the climax of the story would send chills or vibes or other expected emotions from your audience. The fourth element of plot is falling action. The action winds down. Loose ends get tied up. Events are resolved, and we learn the results of the protagonist's actions during this stage. Let's have this example of falling action from Harry Potter. So after everything that has happened, the accusations, the conspiracy, and the sufferings of the main character, his problems are starting to get handy. Let's have the last element of plot, which is denouement or resolution. The goal of this stage is to resolve and to end the conflicts. Could be positive, negative, or neutral. This is the end of the story. And so, let's have the denouement or the resolution of Harry Potter as the example. To sum it up, in this session, you have learned about the 9 basic elements of a film: characters, setting, plot, conflict, resolution, theme, scenes, dialogue, and visuals. Also, you have learned Gustav Freytag's presentation of the 5 elements of a plot: exposition, rising action, climax, falling action, and denouement in his dramatic pyramid, or popularly known as the Freytag's pyramid. So let's proceed to comprehension checkpoint. So there are 2 activities that will be presented here, which are inclusive also in your module. So you will be using your module to accomplish these activities. Exercise 1 is crossword puzzle. You simply solve the crossword using the list of clues. Exercise 2, plot the plot. You are given a story in your module. You have to read the story, then accomplish the graphic organizer, presenting a simple plot that would summarize the important events in the story. Again, please refer to your activity sheet number 2 for the copy of the story and the graphic organizer. Be guided by the rubric. To end this session, let me leave to you this thought to ponder on. Plot makes the character just as history makes the man. This is all for now. Goodbye for now, my dear learners. See you on our next session.